Brain aneurysms can be a scary thing to deal with, especially because it can happen without warning. This morning on Ask a Specialist, we'll talk about what you need to know with Dr. Samuel Tsappidi, neurointerventional surgeon at the Queen's Medical Center. Good morning, doctor. How are you doing this morning?
Good morning, Ross. Thank you for having me.
Now, first off, can you explain what is an aneurysm?
Great question. An aneurysm is a swelling in a blood vessel wall, just like a blister or a bump that happens in the brain. It can happen from birth, but develops later in life, or it can happen from trauma where the vessel tears, just like layers in a tire, and causes a swelling with collection of blood in between. That causes a weak part in the blood vessels in the brain that can eventually rupture over time.
Now, what are some of the warning signs that you could be having one?
Well, unfortunately, with aneurysms, they're rarely presenting with active symptoms. The few times we see them develop without any warning would be if you have eye problems, where you can have an enlargement of your pupil or your droopy eyelid. That is an impending rupture, but most of them, they happen without any warning. The first symptom you look for is the worst headache of your life, or a headache that's very intense and different from the usual nature of your headaches that you have. But majority of the time, we don't see any warning signs other than the headaches. In a few cases, you can have a large aneurysm that can swell and cause symptoms of dull headaches and other deficits in the brain, just like a brain tumor, but those are very rare with large aneurysms.
Now, Dr. Tsappidi, what are some of the treatment options available?
There are plenty available. Currently, more than 90% of aneurysms are treated by minimally invasive means, where we go access the brain vessels from the wrist or the groin, and we put catheters in that location, deploy some coils or stents or devices like web, among multiple options that will essentially seal and secure the aneurysm so it doesn't bleed in the future. 10% of aneurysms are treated with open surgery, but majority are done by minimally invasive means. And one other thing to mention is these procedures are done overnight, where you just come to the hospital, spend a day, you go home the next day and go back to work the day after, or travel or do any of the activities that you normally like to do without limitations.
And doctor, finally, are there ways to prevent aneurysms?
Unfortunately, no, because majority of aneurysms are incidental, picked up from family histories in 10% of the population here. They can also happen in some patients who have kidney cysts, miscarriages, or even hyperextensible joints. But there's no clear way to prevent them from happening. But the one way you can reduce the risk would be if you're a smoker, to reduce the risk by fourfold by stopping or quitting smoking. Also with uncontrolled blood pressure. And lastly, any other avenues like recreational drug use, which we see in Hawaii a lot with methamphetamine abuse, that can increase the risk of aneurysms to rupture, but there's no definite way to prevent it, unfortunately. And one last thing I do like to mention is compared to the mainland, where the incidence of aneurysms are 5 to 7%, we see a little bit more higher numbers in Hawaii because of the Japanese influence as well here, where it's comparable to the Japanese and Finnish population ratios, which are close to 10% incidence.
Now, to learn more about the services being offered by the Queen's Neuroscience Institute, you can visit their website at www.queens.org. Click on services, then click on neuroscience, or you can just give them a call at 808-691-2727. Thank you very much, Dr. Tsappidi, for your time this morning, and have a great day.
Thank you for having me.